Today, we are going to see how to use the grid property in WeWeb. Grids are everywhere. You can use them to display a list of categories, a list of projects, and if you add some variations to it, you can call that the bank to grid to showcase features. Why should you use grid instead of Flexbox? Flexbox is great to align items on one axis as it offers properties like justify content and align items. Potentially, you can even create grids with Flexbox, but it would take a bit more steps and involve wrapping elements into divs to make it work for more complex layouts. We'll see that grids offer properties that allow you to do all of that in a bit simpler way. So let's see it in action. We'll start by trying and recreate the simple grid. The simple grid is widely used to display a bunch of categories, a playlist, where all the children in that grid have the same dimension. Let's try with an example taken from the Headspace website where they display a bunch of categories. Before we jump into WeWeb, I think it's better to try and visualize the grid before trying to build it. So if we look at that grid, we can see that we have three columns and we also have five lines, five rows. So let's go into WeWeb and try to recreate that layout. And I've prepared some cards to display into our grid, but these are just regular cards with no dimension, just a background. And the wrapper is still a flex. We see that they are horizontally aligned as the default properties. And now we're going to add the new grid property on the display. As we do that, we see that the elements are stacked vertically. And we see that we have these new properties inside of our grid section. And on the direction, we leave it at row for now. And on the columns, we are going to add our three columns. We can see now that it almost looks like the result that we want. We have our three columns and we have our five lines. And notice that we haven't specified any rows on there yet. And that's because our rows are auto-generated, and since we have 15 items in a grid of three columns, then we also have five lines, because when one row is filled on the three columns, then it will go to the line until we have our five rows. By default, the unit of a column is a fraction. A fraction, FR, stands for a portion of the axis. For instance, our three columns here all have one fraction. But if we input two on the first column, then we see that it takes twice as much space as the other columns that have one fraction. If we input two fractions on the second column, then we only have third column that is taking twice less space as the two others. For our example, we just want them equal. And then to complete our design, we just need to add some gap, some column gap and some row gap. And now we see that we have the layout that we want. So that's it for the simple grid. And yeah, it just takes just a few clicks to get there. Now with this layout, we can also make it responsive. So if we go into tablet mode, maybe we just want to have two columns here. So we just need to delete one and it will resize automatically to have two columns. And the same goes for the mobile breakpoints. We can have only one item and then they will wrap accordingly. And now for our second example, let's try and create a bento grid or more complex grid. And for that example, we'll take this layout taken from the pitch.com website where they have a beautiful grid showcasing the team members. And we can see that there is a bit more complexity to the grid, and from the first glance, we can't really see the grid or consistent grid. But if we try and divide the grid now, we have our first line here, second here, and third here. And we can see that if we have a two-column grid, then it won't really work because each column doesn't have the same width. But if we try and divide that by six, then we have a grid where every item can fit nicely and have their own dimensions on each row. So let's try to recreate that in WeWeb. On our new grid here, I will add three new columns. Like so. So we have six columns. Then we saw that the first one was taking five columns. And we can do that by clicking on that card and access the new properties available. We need the columns and row span to have the behavior that we want. So on the column span, we saw that it's taking five columns, and on the row span, it's taking only two. So with that, we see that we have the same results. We have the two items on the right that are stacking vertically, and that's what we want. On the second row, we see that the fourth item is taking half of the grid of the row, and that equals to three on our case. And the fifth item is taking also three columns. And there we have it for the second row. And for the last one, it's a bit similar to the first row that we had, the first two rows, but inversed. So for that, our sixth cell is basically the same. And the seventh one, which is this one, will be taking five columns and two rows. And then the eighth one will wrap below the sixth, because here it's already the second row. And the other ones are not present, so we can go ahead and delete that. And there we have it. We have a nice variation in layout without much trouble. And then just one last example from the Etsy website, where they display some projects and where they have this header, the kind of header that's taking two rows. So if we try again and try to imagine this grid, we have four columns and two rows. And we see that the first element is taking two rows instead of one. Let's try and do it in WeWeb also. We have the basis, and now we want the first element to take two rows. So I could go ahead and use the row span and set it to two, which will have the same result as this one. But for the example, we use the second properties here. And the column and row positions are waiting for two values, the start value and the end value. And to understand what is the start and the end value, I'm going here on this website called coderpad.io, where they put a really well-made guide on CSS grid. And they have this schema here that explains how to count inside of a grid. To count the column position here, we start at 1, then here will be position 2, 3, and 4. On the row, same, we start by 1, 2, and 3. So if we try and apply that to our first element here, on our row position here, make it start to 1, and it will end to 1, 2, 3. So 3 will make it spread to two rows. That's how you achieve that layout. And the column position will work the same way. These properties are nice if you want to customize the position of your elements compared to the first one, where you just want to shape its dimension. For instance, if I want to make it start on the second column, I could input 2. So it moves to the second position here, and I could make it spread to 1, 2, 3, 4, and we'll take this much space. And what's nice on the grid positioning is that it's all wrapping accordingly to our elements here. Quick guide on how to use the grid property to create basic grids or a bit more complex grids. And you can definitely use it with the flexbox property, and they go well together depending on the use cases. And yeah, happy building.